Hi, I'm Rick Anthony, and welcome to the Someone You Should Know podcast, the podcast that focuses on musicians, authors, and interesting people. We like to say we're making a difference one artist at a time. So sit back, have a cold one, and get ready to meet someone you should know. Today's guest is actually doing double duty today. He's got a brand new full-length album coming out, and also he's part of a duo that had a new EP released in February. He's from my old stomping grounds in Colorado Springs. Will you please welcome Richard Raymond II? How are you, my friend?
I'm all right. You know, just cleaned up from everywhere. So
he is a new dad, by the way, folks. And we had to kind of preempt the interview here because the little one had a little bit of an accident there. So what is the name of the new addition to the family?
Her name is Dorothy Rose.
Wonderful. Beautiful name. Yeah. Beautiful name. And we wish her very, very well. Well, you've been busy, too. Besides being a new dad, you've got a new album out and you've got an EP out. What do you do for an encore?
Make more, I guess. I had most of that done before she was born, so that I just waited to release it all.
Oh, that's awesome. Very good. Very good. You don't want to steal her thunder, right?
Right.
First, let's address the solo project. You grew up native from Chicago. Whereabouts in Chicago were you from?
I grew up in a town called Lamont, Illinois.
Yeah, I know exactly where it is. There's a golf course there, isn't there? Isn't Cog Hill right there in that general area?
Yes, it is.
Awesome. Very good. And you live in the Springs there. I used to live in the Springs, too. I used to live near Airport and Academy. How far are you from there?
I don't know off the top of my head. I haven't been here long enough to know exactly.
Oh, really? So you're brand new to the Springs there. It's a beautiful area. I spent several years there. And nice. Every weekend we had the kids somewhere in the Rockies just goofing off. Brand new album is called Glimmers. Yeah, let's talk us about the new album you got going on.
It's 11 songs, I think. Mm-hmm. Try to make each one different than the last. Mm-hmm. It's kind of it's a bit more electronic than anything I've ever done. Some of these songs go back like since I think even maybe the beginning of the pandemic.
Last 3 years or so you've been working on this particular project. How would you describe your style of music for this solo project?
Well, it's hard to say. I guess I would say it's kind of like it's more instrumental, kind of dreamy, I guess. I've always been kind of dreamy.
Kind of ambient type the style there?
Yeah. Yeah, all a little right. bit with like a lo-fi hip-hop influence on some of it.
Very first song is actually coming out worldwide today called D's Nuts. I love that playful name. you see it everywhere nowadays, but D's Nuts, what's the backstory on D's Nuts?
The backstory is I had a dry spell that went over a year and I was just kind of, I think I was listening to Mac Miller at the time. I'd never really rap, but I was just like, yeah, let's go for it. I just wrote that verse. I was just messing around, but I was amused by it and I kind of showed it to all my friends and they thought it was hilarious. And I was like, all right, I guess I have to include this somewhere because this is probably, even though it was a comical response, it's almost like the best response I'd gotten out of any of the stuff that I've been working on. So when I'm like uncomfortable, I feel like that's when I have to go do something because it means that's where like most people would stop. So
there you go. You have the fortitude to press on. D's Nuts is out today and we're going to play it right now from the album Glimmers from today's podcast guest Richard Raymond II right here on the Someone You Should Know podcast.
I roll my own like you roll your cuffs. that's been touched.
There you go, D's Nuts from Richard Raymond II, today's podcast guest. You play several instruments in your repertoire. What did you learn first?
Drums, I guess.
Really? Okay. Very good. Yeah. How old were you when you picked up the drums?
I think I was about like 13. I had like half a drum kit in my garage, and then I didn't really have anything for a while, but I played like a Guitar Hero drums.
Oh, of course. Yeah. Yeah.
When I was like 18, I got a drum kit again, but I feel like I never stopped because drumming is the one thing you can always practice.
Right. And that you got to have that to start with, basically. You got to have a beat, right?
Yeah.
All right. How about your musical influences?
Man, they're all across the board. I guess like when I first started playing, I was a big Radiohead fan.
Oh, I love Radiohead. Yeah.
As well, those were like probably my two biggest influences. Mm-hmm. But with the Richard Raymond II stuff, I've kind of always been a big fan of Aphex Twin as well.
Okay.
And so this was kind of me trying to do some stuff. I've always listened to electronic music as well.
Right.
But I didn't really have the production knowledge or some of the tools to make that type of stuff. Yeah, that was kind of the reason I made a new name and relaunched, so to speak.
Awesome. Well, good. Yeah. Good. We got to play another song from the album called Glimmers. This one's got another playful name too. It is called Another Side of Ranch. The story behind that song, bud?
My wife and I were drunk and we were messing around. This was years ago in Chicago, and I don't know, we were just, you know, can I get some more ranch? I don't know if we were eating and had ranch, and I just took a phone recording and had this guitar instrumental and just remembered that recording and just kind of cut it up and threw it in there to make it more entertaining.
It is very cute. I really like it. So that's your wife on the other end there?
Yep.
Awesome. Yep. And your lovely wife's name, to give her some credit on this.
Sammy.
All right. Very good. Featuring Sammy, here is Richard Raymond II from his album called Glimmers. This is Another Side of Ranch on the Someone You Should Know podcast.
Can I get another side of ranch? When you get a chance, can I get another side of ranch?
Precisely what we all need, Another Side of Ranch. Another song from the album called Glimmers from Richard Raymond II. Richard, you've been a musician for a while. You've played out here and there. Any particular stories where things didn't go as planned? This next section is called Tales from the Road, and it's all those infamous road stories of things that happened getting to a gig, something that happened once you got there, something that happened backstage, on stage, something like that. Anything stand out?
Yeah, I guess so. I mean, it didn't really go wrong, but this is the first story that popped into my head. I don't know what year this would have been, maybe 2018 or something. Mm-hmm. My band, Lime Forest, we were playing this small festival in central Illinois called BuzzFest.
BuzzFest.
And one of my bandmates and I ate some mushrooms before we went on stage.
Okay.
we each had like an eighth, so a full dose right before we went on, so we knew we'd have plenty of time before anything got hairy. And we played great. Everything went great. But after the fact, like, somehow word got out. And, like, but the story everyone was saying that, like, I don't remember what it was, some exorbitant amount of tabs of acid that each one of us took beforehand.
Oh, like, so they say they it converted it from mushrooms to acid. Yeah.
Right. Okay. And like way more than we had done. And it like kind of became this like lore of the festival. And that just goes to show, that's like a little excerpt on how social psychology works. And it was like, that's not what happened. Like, even though everyone thinks we're like cool now, like, I would rather it, you know, I don't know, just it was weird.
So rather have been truthful than actual made up. But it's kind of like Ozzy,
exactly.
You know, you know, he did this. Well, Ozzy said, I don't remember doing that. I mean, I did a lot of drugs in my time frame, but right. I don't remember doing that. But all right, that's an interesting one. Where was BuzzFest at? Was it in Chicago? It, or where?
Near Macomb, Illinois.
Oh, I know exactly where that is. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, I don't even remember the name of the town. It's all very small towns over there. So, and this was years ago, but in that area.
All right. What else should everyone know about this particular project that you've got on Glimmers? What else should we know about that before we move on to something else?
I guess that you know, the creation of this record kind of coincided with like the increased focus on my yoga practice. So a lot of this stuff was kind of meant to be songs that could be played like in a yoga class.
Oh, how cool. All right. That's very, very cool. I like that. So you're into yoga too. All right. Very good. I'm learning a whole lot about you now.
Yeah, my wife's an instructor, and I always enjoy her playlists, and some of the stuff that she plays is kind of similar.
Awesome.
Not quite, but you know, that was where I was kind of pulling from.
Let's talk socially. What your links to your material? What would be the best place for anyone who wants to get your brand new album out? Or where would we go if we needed to follow you? Your website, socially? Where are you on social media?
You can follow me on Instagram. My handle is Richard_Raymond_II, like the second.
Okay.
Same name across the board. I really am only on Instagram, but if you want to follow me on Facebook, it's the same name.
Okay.
If you want to just send me $5, it's the same name on Venmo.
All right.
And then all streaming services. The album won't be out when this is released, but the single will be out.
Right.
I also have quite a few singles I put out before that. That's all Richard Raymond II. I try to keep pretty consistent
there. All right. Very good.
I grabbed that name. That is my real name minus my last name. And it hadn't been taken, so I just jumped on it.
All right. Well, by the way, we'll have all the links in the show notes. So just scroll on down to the show notes and we'll include all those links there. Now, I said in the open, not only are you doing the album, but you're part of a jazz soul duo called the Old 45s. I got a brand new EP that came out in February called Wasatch Sawatch. Two names I'm very familiar with. They're both Ute. I know Wasatch means mountain pass, and Sawatch, I believe, means blue earth or middle earth.
Cool. You know more than we did. We just knew their street names.
They were street names also in downtown Colorado Springs, too.
Yeah.
Yeah. I lived there for several years, and the Springs were just a wonderful place. And I remember Wasatch and Sawatch were downtown streets. Is that where the title came from?
Yeah. So our first EP we named Cascade, which is a street near where I live. Uh-huh. And Pete, my bandmate, it was like, how about we say Wasatch Sawatch, but we could be saying it wrong. I don't know. I was like, sure. Yeah, sounds good. But I like it. I really like the artwork, which he kind of came up with the whole idea, but it needed a little tightening up. And my wife's a graphic designer, so her and I kind of refined it. But it was a full group effort, and I think it's really cool.
Awesome. Very good. Well, I'll tell you what, you're talking about Pete. Is that your co-writer, your bandmate there? Let's give him a little. Pete? Yeah.
Pete is, he's an enigma. He's from Virginia. He's there mm-hmm. when we have a gig. Aside from that, it's about a coin flip, whether or not he'll make it.
Okay.
He plays piano and guitar. Mm-hmm. And he writes pretty much all of the material for old 45s. Mm-hmm. And when we perform live, 90% of what we're doing is just on the spot. So he has a great ability to just compose on the fly.
Really, very extemporaneous. Very cool. Awesome.
Yeah.
Very good.
He's super great.
All right.
He's got great style. He's always well-dressed.
Oh, very good. Very good. You guys playing out sometime in the near future that we should know about if you happen to be in the Springs?
I'm pretty sure we're playing on April 8th, either April 8th or April 9th at the Perk downtown. That's kind of our usual stopping grounds. Okay. They just kind of let us play there whenever we want. So
awesome. Very good. We're going to wrap up the show with a song from the new EP, a song called Memphis, not Memphis, but Memphis. Let's
that was all. That was Pete as well on the name there.
What's Pete? What was the story behind that song?
I have no clue.
This is all to blame Pete then, huh? Yeah, it's a great song, though.
Yeah, my guess is he made him think of Memphis blues or something, uh-huh. and he just put a little spin on it.
All right. This is from the album Wasatch Sawatch, from the old 45s, the other portion of Richard Raymond II's life that he does. He's a new father. He's a solo artist. He's in a duo. He does it all. And I thank you so much for being part of our Someone You Should Know podcast family, man. Thanks for being on the show.
Thanks so much for having me.
This is Rick Anthony thanking you again for listening to this episode of Someone You Should Know. Now, if you're an aspiring musician or an established musician that's looking for a little exposure, I invite you to drop us a line at someoneyoushouldknowpodcast@gmail.com. That's someoneyoushouldknowpodcast@gmail.com. Also, I invite you to tell a friend about the Someone You Should Know podcast. I thank you for tuning in this time, and I invite you to check us out next time on the Someone You Should Know podcast, because you never know who's going to show up. Until next time, remember, God loves you, and so do I.